the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the martyr Saint Boniface be our advocate, O Lord, that we may firmly hold the faith he taught with his lips and sealed in his blood, and confidently profess it by our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul said, King Agrippa, I was not disobedient to the heavenly vision. On the contrary, first to those in Damascus and in Jerusalem and throughout the whole country of Judea, and then to the Gentiles. I preached the need to repent and turn to God and to do works given evidence of repentance. That is why the Jews seized me when I was in the temple and tried to kill me. But I have enjoyed God's help to this very day. And so I stand here testifying to small and great alike, saying nothing different from what the prophets and Moses foretold, that the Messiah must suffer, and that as the first to rise from the dead, he would proclaim light both to our people and to the Gentiles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial song. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Praise the Lord, all you nations. Glorify him, all you peoples. Go out and tell the world, tell the good news. For steadfast he is kindness toward us, and fidelity of the Lord endures forever. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia,
alleluia. I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. Know my sheep, and mine know me. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. A hired man who is not a shepherd and whose sheep are not his own sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. And I know mine, and mine know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you. celebrate the feast day of Saint Boniface. Born around 680 AD, lived to 754, about 74 years. He was a significant man in the church from that period. It seems that when he was a very young boy, there were missionary monks who visited his house, and he was much taken with them. He was so inspired that he wanted to have a religious education. And he was born of a noble family, could have probably done most anything with his life, but he apparently begged his father to go to a monastery school. At the age of 7, he went to Exeter. And he began studying and did quite well. At the age of 14, he was moved to the Benedictine Nursling Abbey in Winchester. And he studied under Abbot Winbert. He was remarkable in his studies, and he showed a remarkable grasp of the scriptures. And this is absolute fact, since it's documented and noted in the letters that he wrote, how bright he was and how much he understood. He was also well versed in history, grammar, rhetoric, and poetry. I think the aspect of being well established in rhetoric was important at an early age too, because his academic achievements led him to becoming eventually the director of the school. He was ordained in the year 1715, about then, and he must have been about 35 years of age. He was a very successful teacher and preacher. And during all this time, authorities say that his family wanted him to move towards a more secular option rather than his chosen interest. But he, in this position, gained quite a bit of fame, known pretty widely in England by so many people. But he wanted to do something else with this background and training that he had. He wanted to become a missionary. Of all things, he wanted to go to Friesland, and this was around the year 718, essentially this is Germany, and he wanted to evangelize pagans. What a remarkable calling. These pagans were a pretty rough crowd. Something that really stood out, I think, when he first went there, the pagans worshipped Thor and other gods. There was a huge oak tree that was known as the Thor Oak, and they believed that it was pretty much indestructible because it was protected by the god Thor. If anybody tried to do anything to that tree, they would be struck down by lightning. Boniface took an axe and chopped the tree down. Not only that, he took the lumber from the tree and built a chapel. This was pretty impressive to the pagans of that area, And he converted thousands to Christianity. A remarkable achievement. That was just one of the early things that he did. He established a number of monasteries. He built churches. There's so many things that he did, and there was so much going on during this period in his life that it's difficult to do more than touch on these things in the amount of time that I have to talk about St. Boniface. But he stands out as an evangelist. And he's regarded as a unifier of Europe. He's also considered a Germanic national figure. And there's no doubt that his efforts to convert pagans helped shape Western Christianity. Did some remarkable things. In 754, the year that he was martyred, he was going back to the Frislanders. This is northern Netherlands. And these folks, he had been gone for so long that they were kind of slipping back into, lapsing back into their pagan ways. So he wanted to go back and move them towards Christianity again. On his way there, there were a marauding band of criminals who robbed people. These marauders attacked him and his followers. There were, I think he had about 52 followers with him, and they were carrying these wooden chests that had scrolls and sacred documents in them. These marauders thought they were carrying gold, riches. Well, it's said that Bishop Boniface, Saint Boniface, raised a book, a codex, to ask for spiritual protection before he was struck down. And the marauders, of course, these pagans, they broke open the chest. They were disappointed that they didn't have the treasures, and they tried to destroy all the documents that the chests held. And in the field, people found the book, supposedly, that St. Boniface held, and it has a deep cut in it, as if someone hit it with an axe or pierced it with a sword. So if you see pictures of Boniface, sometimes he's pictured holding a book with a sword through the book. I think it's easy to see why, in all the accomplishments and his great faith until his death, that he never let anything come between him and his love for Christ. Thousands of years later, our great Saint Mother Teresa would have given him that advice. Let nothing come between you and love. Peace be with you.
Coming together as one family in faith, let us offer to God our prayers and our needs.
For all who have vowed themselves to God, that with his help they may faithfully keep to their resolve, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace among nations, that delivered from all turmoil, the peoples may serve God in freedom of heart, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the elders who suffer from isolation or sickness, that they may be strengthened by our love of them as brothers and sisters, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered in this sacred place by faith and devotion and by love and reverence for God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ourselves gathered here, that as God does not cease to sustain us with the things of this life, we may know how to use them in such a way that we may hold even now to the things that endure forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the Barrington family for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all of our intentions, spoken and unspoken, joined through the intercession of St. Thomas the Apostle, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Offering all our prayers to the Father, let us conclude with a prayer in honor of the Most Blessed Trinity.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, it is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Sanctify your offerings by your blessing, O Lord, we pray, and by your grace may we be set afire with the flame of your love, through which St. Boniface overcame every bodily torment, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give order to their faith, to their endurance you grant firm resolve. In their struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration. And we with all the host of angels cry out, and without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy.
Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. So we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace, George.
Peace, George.
Peace, George.
Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George.
Peace,
George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace, George. Peace,
George. Lamb of God.
You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Amen.
May the sacred mysteries of which we have partaken, O Lord, we pray, give us that determination which made your blessed martyr Boniface faithful in your service and victorious in suffering through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Prayer to St. Michael.
Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the divine powers, thrust into hell, Satan and all the other evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Divine praises.
Blessed be God. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus, the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the consoler. Blessed be the great mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.